If you're wondering what IKEA products I love to use in my quilt studio, you're going to want to watch this video because I'm going to show you those. Hi, I'm Kim Jamieson-Hirst of Chatterbox Quilts, and in today's video, we're going behind the scenes in the Chatterbox Quilt studio to show you the different IKEA products I use in my studio and how I use them in my studio. Now, I did a previous video, that talked about different IKEA products that you might not have thought would work really well in your quilt studio. And one of the comments that I got on it said, you know, the only thing that'd be better if you showed us how you use those products. So that's what I'm doing in today's video. We're going to start at the back of the studio with my pressing station, which is composed of several different IKEA elements. So I wanted to show you the different units I talked about. So we've got two Kallax units here on the bottom. They're turned sideways. I have another one at the back that's actually turned facing us, and you'll see more of that in just a moment. We also have an IKEA tabletop here. You can buy different tabletops without the legs. So that's just a tabletop without the legs. Two complement drawers. There's supposed to be another one in here to complete the whole thing, but it's out of stock, of course, and has been for over a year, so we'll see what happens there. In the meantime, I've been able to store my light table in here, and my Martelli rotating pressing and cutting mat are in there. On top, I have my portable pressing surface that I've made, and it's covered with IKEA fabric, of course. So when it gets stained and I want to change it, I can change the top. I will choose some new IKEA fabric, whatever they may have that's new and exciting at the time, and we'll recover that. So now I'm going to show you a little bit more underneath so you can see how the Kallax units are arranged and what I use them for. So let's pull back the curtain and find out what's underneath here. Oh, and by the way, the curtain, IKEA too. I just cut it off and it helps to hide what I've got down here. So you can see, hopefully, the Kallax unit at the back. So these come in different sizes. The ones I have here are all four bins or cubbies, I should say. As you can see, the top ones, I've just got them open. I've got various things stored in there, but the bottom ones, I've actually got the glass doors on them so I can see what's in there, but yet they're protected from the dust that happens and fur, especially that happens in my studio. So you can see how that one's facing out. So that's part of the U shape. You can see the other ones here are facing this way. So I've got these two Kallax units that are facing in, if you will, as opposed to the back one, and they will hold these Trofast bins. I use these in most of them to hold various items, and they're all labeled, and I can either pull them out from the inside, or typically I do it from the outside because these cubbies go all the way through, they're open. And in the top ones on this particular side, I have all my Martelli templates stored in here. So when I want to pull out some of these Trofast bins and work with them or get out whatever's in them, I can just reach down, pull them up. They're all labeled. I have a lot of my embellishments in these, and then I can just take them out and get out what I need and then just put them right back in there. So they fit really nicely. A small one and a medium Trofast will fit really nicely in these Kallax cubbies. So that's how my pressing area is set up with IKEA items. Let's move on to another area in my studio. Now we're moving up the side of my studio to where I have two Billy bookcases that hold my fabrics. Okay, so I'll just give you a quick peek inside one of them. They are all nicely folded, aren't they? And this is where I keep all my fabric stash. And the thing about the Billy bookcases that I chose to do with these particular ones is I chose to put doors on them, and I chose to put half glass, half solid on them. Okay, all glass I thought would be a little much and a little too busy. All solid I thought would make me feel a little closed in. So you do have a choice on doors with the Billy. That's what I chose. And here I have another Kallax unit. This is one of the 8 cubby ones. Remember I said they come in different sizes. So this particular one has some paperwork up top, some decorations, that type of thing. But you'll notice that I have doors on here too, but these are wooden doors as opposed to the glass ones that I have in my pressing area. So what do I have in here? Well, all kinds of things. Let's hope they don't fall out when I open the door. So I actually have my Halloween fabrics here, and I have my Christmas fabrics here, and some wide backs as well, as you can see sticking out there. So I do keep those separate in my fabric stash. In the bottom area, I have my AccuQuilt Go dyes on the one side, and I have some of my mats and some other different kinds of dyes over here as well. So those are all kept behind those doors in that area. Now I want to show you the Kallax unit that lives next to my sewing machine. So this is the narrow and low one because they come in different sizes, as do most IKEA products. And oh, another thing I wanted to point out to you is there's lots of different cool plastic plants. So if you're in the basement like I am and you want some decoration, some greenery, you can pick up some of those at IKEA as well. Now let's take a look and see what I keep in this particular Alex. So let's take a look at what I have in these drawers in Alex. And this is as fully extended as they go, by the way, in case you're wondering. So the top drawer, I have various miscellaneous things that I would use when I am stitching. That's really what I have in all of the drawers here. So I will have my feet for my Janome machine, additional accessories, bobbins, things like that as well. Because I have two Janome machines in my studio, I actually have the feet for my second Janome in here as well. And continuing down, I also have spools of thread. This is all glide polyester thread I have in there, so you get an idea of what you can put in those drawers as far as depth. In the bottom, well, it's really not very interesting, but masking tape, my sew slip 2 for when I'm free motion quilting, that type of thing. So that's one of the Alex drawers units I have in my studio. And you'll also notice that it's on wheels, so it moves around. I like things to move around in my studio. Those wheels you have to buy as an additional purchase. And on the side, I've used some command hooks, not from IKEA, and I have some of my rulers on them. I also have some stencils on these particular ones as well. So I also have some other Billy bookcases in my studio, and these are ones that I have full-length glass doors on them. So remember I told you had different door options, so you can see what that would look like. And this is where I keep my most used quilting books. I also have two or three other units that are open around the corner, and these ones are used for their proper purpose, for storing books, and all the books are organized, but we're not going to get into how that's done in this video. One of the favorite things I have from IKEA in my studio is this Raskog cart. As a matter of fact, I have three of them in my studio, two in this color and one in a lighter aqua color. They change the colors all the time. So this particular one I have set up with my quilting books, so ruler quilting, free motion quilting. So I've got them split out in the two areas here because I like to go through them and practice and learn that type of thing. And actually this is another Trofas bin, and what's in there is my quilting rulers or templates, some people might call them. So these are the ones I actually use when I'm quilting on a quilt, not the ones for cutting. So that's what I have in this particular one, but there's other things you can store or use your Raskog carts for too, so let me show you that. So there's other things you can use the Raskog cart for. You can use it for sort of a portable pressing or cutting station. So here I've got my portable pressing mat on it. So I've got a small Rowenta iron that I could use. This will lift up and there's storage in that top area there. You could also put a cutting mat, a small cutting mat on top and use it for a cutting station. You can get these small little holders, these little pockets I call them, where you can keep your rotary cutter. Maybe I've got a little seam roller in here, whatever utensils that you want to put in there. You can have it right with you and you can just roll it up to your sewing machine and use it, and then, you know, roll it off to store if you're not using it. So lots of different things that you can use these Raskog carts for. Super helpful in your studio. And again, of course, they're on wheels, so you can move them out of the way when you're not using them and just store them elsewhere. I have more Alex units in my studio too. I have a long arm and I have four Alex units underneath it that I keep a variety of things in. So I actually have, you'll only be able to see part of them probably, but I have two of the narrow Alex, like what I have next to my sewing machine, and I have two of the wide ones. So on the wide one here, what I like to keep in it, I have my pins, my needles, you know, things for my long arm. Basically, this whole unit here has different things that I use when I'm quilting on the long arm. Feet, accessories, you know, different things like that. And then in the narrower one is where I keep my thread, stencils. I have some stencils, not a lot, but a few. But I have small cones, and then I get into the bigger cones, and I have them separated out by color. So that's what is in this particular side. What's nice on the ones that are this wide is in the other one I actually have parchment paper, freezer paper, interfacing, fusible web, all those types of things I have in the other unit, and not usually Salem's tail as well. So those are really handy, again, on wheels, so I can pull them in and out. My long arm is on wheels too, so I can move it around as well. But what I really like is the fact that these are under the long arm, because that's underappreciated and underused space. So I have all this storage 4 different units that I can put underneath my long arm to store a variety of items. Let's talk about how you can hang your quilts using IKEA products. So they have a variety of curtain rods. I have one here called Hugod, and most of them come in different, you know, widths, as this one does. The other thing that I have got for this particular one is finials for the end. These are called Blast. Doesn't come with finials. You can get different ones to put on as well. And then I bought these Srillig curtain rings, and they come with either these little clips like I have here, or they also have just little hooks, and they all come in the same package. So the rings, the clips, or the hooks are all together in that Srillig package. So what this allows you to do is to clip your quilts. So if you don't have a quilt sleeve on your quilt, or you want to easily change out your quilts, this is a great system because you can just open the clips. It comes with 10 in it, so you can use as many as you need for your particular quilt, and then you can just have your quilts hang up very easily. So I'm going to show you that next. So here's what a quilt looks like hung up using that system. And you can see how I've just used 5 of the clips to, that was enough for this quilt. You could even have, if you had 2 quilts that aren't huge, you could have, you know, 2 or 3 or however many quilts or wall hangings hung up using this particular system. By the way, if you're wondering, this is called Diamond Bright. It's a pattern that I developed to use in my online membership called The Quilter's Way. And something you must have in your quilt studio, a garbage pail. I have 3 in my studio, 1 at all my sewing machine or stitching areas. So again, IKEA comes to the rescue with a good big sized garbage pail, very economical, and comes in different colors to match your studio decor. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please give it a big thumbs up and share it with your quilting friends. And remember to subscribe and hit the bell so you'll be notified the next time I release a new video. Before you go, I've got some additional videos that I think you'll find helpful. And for more helpful quilting information, be sure to go to my website at www.chatterboxquilts.com. And they look great as earrings as well for the summer season.